portal next to the name was apparently a portal to open up to go to the park.
Ah.
Normally you don't get portals this early.
Yeah. Brass scepter. When you have your wolf out, if you activate them again, they buff you. And that buff has like a cooldown.
I leveled.
I unfortunately did not.
Oh, okay. I did encounter, I think, 2 packs before you joined me.
Yeah.
I'll hang back a little bit.
What is that?
I can hang back a little bit so you can get to mine.
I mean, we're gonna sink them pretty fucking early. Like, these are first levels are super fast.
Leather boots of turtle.
So I'm gonna turn the game's audio down a tiny bit. There we go. Can't hear myself think over the sound of me swinging a sword. Oh yeah.
Oh, if you hit. Hit tab, you can see like the map overlay as you're playing.
Yeah.
Instead of,
I mean, it's,
like,
yeah, it's like mini map in the upper right, or you hit tab and it's like over there.
Yeah.
Entering Traveler's Camp. Oh, I don't know if we both have to click it.
No. It says entering.
Okay.
Oh, there it goes.
That was a lot slower than it was when I was playing on my own on online. Yeah. Kind of weird.
There's 2 of me, and it's centered on the guy that's not moving.
Oh, man. That's, different.
Can I go back?
We can try.
Yeah, it's not letting me go back to that start area.
There's another area. This is literally just a town and then another area, so no, I can go click the other door and see if it, like...
Yeah, I just got a loading screen. Okay, now I'm here. So it did go back. And there's only 1 of me. Alright, I'm not gonna click it again.
Right. So we can be in separate areas. So.
3 minutes into the game and I already discovered a bug.
Yeah.
Love it. Alright, I'm here. And I'm...
Yeah, all I went get through the door in the next webs. Area not realizing that, like, it wouldn't move both of us, but I'll just wait at the door here. There's no enemies at the door.
There's a shop and stuff if you want to do
yeah,
anything.
But they won't have much good here. There's a chest there to open, though, if you didn't see that. And that can help you fill out some item slots. This is one of those games where you tend to only loot things that, like, you're actually going to have
greetings,
a purpose
trouble.
For directly.
Care to
you
see
don't
my
really loot things to sell them.
How do I sell stuff?
It's like shift right click or something.
Oh, hey, look. Nice. Oh, and control is compare. Okay.
Yeah, there's a setting to have the compare always on as well. Alt is a really nice keybind because it, like, will show you more details about the stats and, like, affix level and shit like that.
I think we're just gonna wait for drops.
Yeah, I'm not at this stage, I would definitely wait for drops.
Where's the chest you were speaking of?
It's just to the right of the merchant.
Oh, that one.
Okay. Maybe. And it's...
It looks open and empty.
Oh. Yep. Weird.
Yeah. Maybe it's shared. When we're
maybe,
in multiplayer.
You might have, like, gone into the same instance, but it, like, deleted your items because you left. It's okay. There's plenty of chests to come.
I just clicked it twice. Again. Because it's not like an instant load. It just says entering and then...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it also, like... It's one of those things where holding the mouse as you approach will automatically trigger it.
Well, there's not 2 of me, so there. I've got that going for me.
I have spin to win. There's a chest.
Oh wow. Okay. I will take all of it.
And yeah, only loot stuff if you're actually planning on using it.
Oh, is it shared?
No, it's not that it's shared, it's just that they sell for dog shit.
Okay. You get your gold from the piles, not selling. Alright.
Like, they do technically have a sell value, but it's like, oh, it's 3 gold to sell that two-handed weapon. Like, who cares? It's not worth filling your inventory. And look at this! There's, like, literally one pile in there was worth, like, 100 gold. Eventually we'll figure out what kind of items we want, and then we'll set up loot filters to highlight them special so it's easier to find them.
I don't know how to drop stuff.
You just click it to bring in your cursor, and then click on the open area in the screen.
Oh, okay. Oh, I never even leveled my first level.
You didn't get a point at level 2 anyway.
Oh, okay.
Level 2 just gives you a move. There we go, level 3. Level 3 is where you get your first point. So we should both have a point to put in our tree now.
Okay.
That little plus at the bottom.
When do I get to select Beastmaster? Because that's what I'm going for.
Not for a while.
Okay.
So like you're gonna want to put everything into your base thing for quite a while.
Okay. Ready. Oh, I've got a new thing.
I have a camera.
That's what I have.
+4 melee physical damage, I'll take that.
Take care of that guy.
We unlock our first specialization next level. And that's where your moves get freeze. This hammer throw is actually kind of funny. Want me to put the hammer down?
No, he loves his hammer.
Unfortunately, I don't think there's a lightning bolt for this boss, but. It also does damage on the way back, that's great.
Okay. We're just nuking all these guys.
Yeah. Little area if you like.
Hey, level 4.
That only really lasts for until we get to the purple area, which is like two areas away, not very far. Specialization unlocked.
Oh, are you a little ahead of me now?
Maybe. Yeah. What level are you? Are you still level 3?
Yeah, I thought I was 4, but maybe not.
You can see if you hit C in the upper left, it'll say you're experiencing.
Oh, I'm at 4. Yeah. Okay.
The unlock symbol is the specialization thing. S in general brings up your moves screen. And then you can pick one of the moves to specialize in. Respeccing is pretty easy, so I wouldn't worry too much about selecting wrong early on.
Okay.
Oh, is your bear temporary? Or is it something
it's
else?
It's a wolf.
Yeah,
bear is number 5.
Ah. So, almost there.
Yeah, almost.
My level 5 move is the one I want to specialize in. Because I peeked ahead and it has a perk on it that can summon stuff just from me killing things with it. Ah. And because the game developers are apparently not complete morons, it also gives you a chance to summon the thing when you hit a boss, as opposed to killing.
Ah.
So it's not worthless on bosses. I have a gap closer. Unfortunately, I have to have a target for mine. I think. I'm pretty sure your class gets a leaping move at some point.
This looks like a good time. Bunch of platforms with nooses.
Yeah.
Ugh.
We're in the Divine Era 12 BE. Coming through! It starts. Plus 6 void damage. I will take that. Apparently some people have reported you can do some pretty interesting buggy things if you use other players to sequence break. Or you do quests out of order and stuff. Thankfully we won't have that issue because we're doing it together, but...
Yeah.
Apparently the game gets confused.